guys, welcome back to How To's and Views. This is the Be Classy Q&A from the Pink Lady Chat on Facebook. I'm super excited about this video. I think it's gonna be awesome because this is such a new bag. It's so hard to buy a bag that you haven't seen yet and that you have so many questions about. So first, let's start with some of the just general changes that they made. The Be Classy is actually the new version of the Better Be. The Better Be was a messenger strap with a flap, and tons of Pink Ladies were getting them deflapped and toted. Hence now, the new Be Classy, which is super cool. Now moving forward, all of the Better Bees in all of the new prints will be substituted with the Be Classy. So all you Better Be lovers, I'm sorry, but this is such an awesome bag. I think you're gonna love it just as much, if not more. So let's start with the general features. There are three fairly deep mesh pockets on the inside and one zipper pocket. The mommy pocket is rectangular and I actually really, really love it. I think this is maybe one of the most well-designed mommy pockets that GGB has. So mainly because I feel like the pockets are bigger now. This front pocket actually fits an entire medium set piece height-wise too. So it has two pockets that seem to be extra deep, one zipper pocket, the sunglass case, and of course the classic key fob. This mommy pocket is gusseted, so it's really easy to just drop stuff in. On the back of the bag, the change pad pocket is actually a zipper pocket now, which is super cool because a lot of people use their change pad pockets for things other than the change pad, like day planners or paperwork, which is really nice to be able to zip it so you don't lose anything. And then one huge change is the media pocket is now on the back, not the front. It's kind of nice that it's a little bit hidden and it really makes the look of the front of the bag super streamlined. The bottle pockets are totally different and we'll get to that in a couple minutes. But let's talk about the tote handles. These handles are a rolled tote handle. They're connected by a little silver, I don't even know what they're called. I'm having a brain fart right now. Hardware? Hardware. It's called hardware. Oh gosh. And they're sewn on. There's no way to take this off. The straps are really nice on your shoulder. They're super comfortable. I actually wore it yesterday, like all day while I was like cooking dinner and getting babies in and out of car seats, and it never fell off my shoulder once. Also, I wanted to add that the handle placement is reinforced here. So I don't think we have anything to worry about as far as making the bag too heavy or ripping or anything like that. It looks like GGB really took our concerns into consideration and all four of them are really reinforced. You can really see it. So this bag also has an alternate way of holding it, and that's the messenger strap. Now the messenger strap clips with swivel clips onto the D-rings on the sides. Super easy. And the messenger strap is similar to the BFF strap where it slides on the pad and it only has one side that is adjustable, which I really like. And this hardware has the new GGB like cursive logo on it. I love it, it's so pretty. And the fabric tag is also the new GGB cursive logo, which is super cute. So as far as wearing it messenger style, I really like it. And because of the shape, it feels very similar to the Better Be when it comes to the messenger style. And these straps simply lay right down onto the bag. So I didn't have any issue with it bulging or anything because of these straps. That was a huge concern from my questions that I got, and this definitely I don't think is gonna be a problem. Also on the bottom, it has feet. I love that. It's similar to the BFF and the Be Prepared, where when you put it down, you won't have to worry about it getting dirty. Oh, and of course the silver hardware. How could I forget that? The silver hardware is so awesome. It's similar to the Legacy, except for it's silver. And it's this nice brushed silver, so we won't have to be worried about scratches or scuffs. It will really hide it well. I did get a question about the weight of this bag. I don't know it specifically, but my box was 4 pounds and I had a set in there also. So I'm assuming that this is 2.5 to 3 pounds. And I packed it to the brim and then I wore it around a little bit and it didn't feel super heavy to me. I kind of have the thought though that like if you put a ton of stuff in your bag, it's gonna get heavy. So it didn't feel overly heavy to me, but you know, if you're carrying around a lot of stuff, anything's gonna be heavy. But realistically, 2.5 to 3 pounds for a bag is awesome. So let's get to these bottle pockets. Now, this is like a completely new design. We have not seen anything like this from GGB yet. I love it, these hidden bottle pockets. They open with a zipper and there is so much space in there. I fit 2 medium set pieces in there. Like, crazy, right? The measurements are 5 inches wide, 5 inches deep, and about 8 inches tall. I couldn't really like get a ruler in there, but I'm pretty sure it's about 8 inches. Anything over 8 inches might be a little bit harder. The medium set pieces are about 8.5 inches long and I kind of had to like squish it in, but I got both of them in there. So if they're not super, super packed, you probably could get 2 in there. I put various bottles in there. I had specific questions about the Tommy Tippy that absolutely fit. I feel like most of the sippy cups on the market will absolutely fit. And even the thermos fit. Can you believe that? Like, thermoses are pretty wide. So you really do have a ton of room in there, much more room than I had thought. One of the most asked questions also was, do you lose a lot of internal storage space when you fill up the bottle pockets? And yeah, you do, because they are designed to go internally and to keep the outside of the bag really streamlined. So I felt like when I packed it with a water bottle and a sippy cup, which is generally what people will use, not many people are gonna put thermos in there, I felt like I lost about 3 to 4 inches of internal space. I don't foresee it being a problem for me. I foresee more that I can't just slip my phone in there now. Like, really, that's gonna be my biggest thing that I have to get used to, because I so just put my phone right in the bottle pockets. So I went through and packed it a couple of ways that I feel like will answer a lot of your specific questions. I packed it for being a baby bag, and then I also packed it more of the work style and also a pump bag, so that you guys could see what kind of configurations worked best and how it looks from a bird's eye view. Now, for all of these packing clips, I kept a water bottle, like just a 16-ounce water bottle, plastic water bottle from Kirkland, and then also a sippy cup on the other side. And then I also kept the mommy pocket packed as a mommy pocket with a wallet and some coin purses, and actually had an EpiPen Junior in there and some pens, just like various stuff that we would normally have in our mommy pockets. I also used various set pieces, a quick and a fuel cell, and they're packed with various things representing stuff that you would be using. Now, I'm not gonna go into what was in each of these items. I just want you to know that I didn't pack them each to the brim, but they are pretty full. So generally you can see how much space and capacity this bag has based off of whatever you would put in these items. And I also did keep the change pad in it. Now, the change pad I forgot to talk about before, it is the normal BFF Better Be change pad with the padding in it. So when you are packing it using the change pad that it comes with, you are losing a little bit of space in that back pocket, but you definitely could still fit a day planner or something back there. I had a specific question about whether or not a fuel cell packed with a Tula or an Ergo would fit in there. So I packed it up with a fuel cell and charcoal roses. This has an Ergo in it, and that left room for a large set piece and then some thin items in the pockets. Now, for the second one, I was able to fit a quick, 2 large set pieces, a blanket, and a burp rag. I had a couple questions about cloth diapering using this bag, and also if it's gonna be big enough for 2 in diapers, and I can definitely say yes. This one had 3 cloth diapers, 1 quick, 2 medium set pieces, a blanket, and a burp rag in it. Now let's move on to using the Be Classy as a pumping bag. I have a Medela pumping style, I think it is. I don't know, I don't use it very often, but it's an electric pump. It comes with the base and then all of the accessories. So I was able to fit the base in there, the power cord, and then I filled up a fuel cell with all the accessories, including bottles and the like pumping things, and this fit perfectly with plenty of room. You could definitely even add a couple of medium set pieces, if not a large or a quick on top. Now, moving on to using this bag as a work bag, this absolutely will be amazing for work. So I had a specific question about a 1.5-inch binder, and I actually only had a 2-inch binder on hand. So here is a 2-inch binder, a medium set piece, a large set piece, as well as a spiral notebook. I also took it a little further and I went ahead and put our laptop in a case in there, and then I was able to also fit in a large set piece, a medium set piece, and a spiral notebook. Now, this was a 13-inch laptop with a case on it, and it did make the sides a little bit wide. I think that was more the case than the laptop, honestly, because this case probably could fit a 15-inch laptop. So overall, I would say that you could definitely fit maybe 3 or 4 quicks or a couple of quicks and a couple of set pieces. And if your fuel cell was a little bit less packed than mine, you probably could even do a fuel cell and a quick. One of the other questions that I really wanted to address was the fact that every picture right now makes it look like there's gonna be a gaping hole on the sides and that somebody could like put their hands in. The way they've designed it is that the fabric touches when it's all fully packed. I did also have a few questions on the post about comparing it to the Better Be and also the BFF. Now, I feel like that's a whole nother video in packing and then unpacking it on. I didn't wanna make this hugely long, but in my personal opinion, I'd say that it will pack similarly and vertically like the Better Be, and that it probably will hold a little bit more than the BFF. Also, it definitely will be less than the Super B. That is huge. And I will say that it probably will pack a little bit less than the BRB. Now, I'm sure in future weeks, there will be lots and lots and lots of packing videos on this and you will be able to see, but just to give you a general idea of where it fits size-wise as far as the structured bags go. So I think that's it. I'm pretty sure I covered every single one of your questions in the comments. Thank you so much for submitting these questions. It was really fun to be able to get you guys the insight details so that you can decide whether or not the Be Classy is for you. Thanks so much for watching. Please like this video if you liked it and hit subscribe if you want to see more from me, and come back next time for more how-tos and reviews. Bye.